Welcome to the channel Maths for Graduates. Today we are here to discuss a brand new topic of partial differential equation. We are going to derive wave equation here, okay? So let's continue. Suppose we have given some elastic string of length L, okay? The length of the string is L. It is fixed between two points O and A, okay? If we provide some distortion, then it vibrates between points O and A, okay? Now, let's just say the horizontal axis is x-axis and the vertical axis is given by u, okay, where u is deflection for some horizontal distance x and for some time t, okay. Therefore u is function of x and t, okay. Now consider two points P and Q. It is P and Q, whose horizontal distance is x, and for Q horizontal distance is x plus delta x, okay, and the length of this wire PQ, this is string PQ, is del s, okay. Now consider the motion of a string PQ, okay. Now the tension at PQ will be along its tangent, okay, whose horizontal angle, which makes an horizontal angle of alpha, and for the point Q the tension will be, say this one is T1 and this one is T2, and it makes an angle of beta with horizontal, okay. Now resolving these two components, the horizontal component of the tension T1 will be T1 cos of alpha, and the vertical component will be T1 sine of alpha. Similarly here it will be T2 cos of beta, and this one is vertical component is T1 sine of beta, okay. Now taking motion along x-axis, okay, motion along x-axis, since there is no acceleration along x-axis, therefore it will be T1 cos of alpha minus T2 cos of beta will be 0, since there is no acceleration along x-axis, okay. Now taking motion along y-axis, the net force along y-axis is T1 sine of beta minus, sorry, it is T2, okay, T2 sine of beta minus T1 sine of alpha equals to, this is net force along u axis, okay, along u axis. Then net force equals to mass of length PQ into acceleration, this is A is what, acceleration along u axis, okay. Now writing the rest of the terms as it is, the mass of the length PQ will be what, let to density of the wire, rho is density of elastic string, okay, hence the mass of wire PQ will be density into length of the wire PQ, that is del S. Okay, therefore this small m will be rho del S. Okay, and the acceleration will be what? Acceleration along vertical axis will be del square u over del t square. Okay, now from this equation we can write what? T1 cos of alpha equals to T2 cos of beta, say this whole value equivalent to capital T. Okay, now dividing this whole equation with T, we'll get over T equals to rho del S over T del square U over del T square. Okay, now putting T is what here? T2 cos of beta. Similarly here, it is what? T1 sine of alpha equals to rho del S over T del square U over del T square. Okay, now cancelling these terms. Now writing the rest of the terms, we will get tan of beta minus tan of alpha equals to rho del S over T del square U over del T square. Okay, now we have considered the length of PQ is very small, therefore this del S will be equal to approximately equal to del X. Okay, here del S is approximately equals to del X. Now replacing this one, we'll get del X over T del square U over del T square. Now tan beta is what? Tan beta is the angle at point Q. Okay, hence we can also write it as del U over del X. It is slope. Since it is slope, we can differentiate. U is function of X and T. But the slope at point Q will be del U over del X at point Q. Therefore, since the PQ's point is what? X plus delta X. Therefore, the slope at point Q will be del U over del X at point X plus del X. Okay. Similarly here, it will be del U over del X at point P, and which is what? X. Okay. Now dividing the whole equation with del X, now this is what? From first principle, from definition of derivation, it will be del square U over del X square. Okay, this is equal to what? Rho over T del square U over del T square. Since rho and T both are positive, hence we can write rho over T equals to some constant C square. Okay, hence the equation will be del square U over del X square equals to C square del square U over del T square. Okay, this is the required wave equation for one dimension. Okay, in this video we have discussed wave equation. In the next video we'll find the solution of the wave equation. Okay, if you find this informative, subscribe the channel and like this video. Thank you. Thanks for watching.